welcome to the IES 4 p.m. service. This is a special service today because if you are new to our church, we are celebrating our 19th anniversary. IES is no longer a teenager. We're able to work, rule the world, and do things. Yes. Anyway. So we're excited to have all of you here. Before we go and start into our worship night, would you join me in prayer, please? Father God, we are so thankful for our church. We're so thankful that we have this place that we can call home, that we can worship freely in this country, Father God. Lord, we've come here for you tonight, no one else. We want to encounter you. We want to experience your power, your authority, and your word in our lives. So as we sing the songs, as we hear your word, would you bless us? Would you transform us so we can leave this place renewed of our hope, of our joy, and of our love from you? Thank you, Jesus. In your precious name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Can I invite all of you guys to stand up? What's up, John? Good to see you. Let's put our hands together.
When night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength.
Yeah.
When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me.
That's right.
I've decided I'm not giving up. You won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Feel it breaking out like an echo.
have you guys here. Can't wait to worship someone with you. But before we continue, can I invite all of you guys just to go around, say hello to your neighbors, get out of your seats, maybe linger around a bit, get to know each other, meet some familiar faces, meet some unfamiliar faces. God is good.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your faithfulness, for being so, so good to us. Not because we are good, Lord Jesus, but because you are good. You're a good, good Father, Lord. Love you so much.
Thank you.
Sing, God is so good. Come on, everybody.
God is so good. God is so good.
You're so good.
God, you're so good. You're so good to me.
Thank you, Father. Let's just begin to thank God for His goodness in our lives.
not envy, he does not boast. His ways are higher than mine, his thoughts consume the great unknown. Of this alone I'm sure, my God is love.
God is patient, God is kind,
so kind.
He does not envy,
he
does not boast. His ways are higher than my own, his thoughts consume the great unknown. Of this alone I'm sure, my God is love.
Let's just bask in his love for a moment.
Sing of your love forever. I can sing of your love forever. I can sing of your love forever. I can sing of your love forever.
Let's sing that one more time. Forever.
Hi, my name is Jane. I'm part of the worship team here at Encounter, and today I would like to do a little testimony. The first time when I entered this room a while back, I would never imagine that I would actually standing here and worshiping God and giving out my testimony. This is the testimony of God's guidance and faithfulness in my life in the midst of my difficulties. You see, at that point, my life was just a mess. I just lost my dad due to the cancer. And at the same time, our family had financial struggles. And added to that, I was going through a hardship in my marriage. Due to their circumstances, I was sad, I was disappointed, I was angry, and I had anxiety taking over me. I felt so much burden that I've been crying and crying for months, and I felt like a constant sadness, and I feel like my chest is just gonna explode anytime. It's too much for me to bear, right? And I couldn't bear it on my own. With all of my brokenness, and as I sat here listening to a sermon, it says that the word of God has the power to release us from oppression and to redeem. And that point of time, Pastor Anthony explained to me that even when I'm faithless all this time, God will still be faithful to me. Because God cannot deny himself, that it is his attribute and nature. I believe that God was personally speaking to me that day. Another week, Pastor Jesus shared me that we have to give our right to be selfish. It will give us freedom. And letting Jesus take the wheel and giving up to our own ways to yield and to surrender. As I heard those words, I broke down in tears. And I felt that I was constantly ignoring God and somehow I was letting God down all the time. I said to myself that I wanted to be free and I wanted to be healed. And at that moment, I decided to surrender all of me to God. My sadness, my brokenness, my life, my everything, and ask God to take full control of me. I know that this is a battle that is too big for me to fight on my own, and that I'm not meant to go through it alone. God spoke to me, "Be still and know that I am God." And he told me to be strong and courageous, that God will fight the battles for me. As I start believing his promises, I started to see God's work in my life, changing me from the inside out. And for the first time after a long, long, long time, I felt peace in my heart and my mind. This is hard. And I was able to receive his forgiveness and I felt love. I found hope again through Jesus. God is healing me and humbling me and shaping me through my dark times. He taught me to be a better person, the person God wanted me to be. And through this process, God has clarified my perspective in life. As in presence, is everything perfect today? Far from it. But I know God is still at work in me. And I will continue to submit and trust him. I believe that God has bigger plans in my life. I know that God will continue to strengthen my heart even more for me to continue to love even the midst of hurt. God promised to me that what's ahead of me is always more than what's behind me. And I believe that my salvation is just not an experience for me to enjoy, but it is a gift for me to share. Thank God that I can share this goodness and faithfulness in my life. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Shay. Wow. God is good. So good to us, Lord Jesus. May we all completely surrender to you, Lord Jesus. Even through our hardships, we want more of you, Lord. May we come to you not only when we need you, everything. We just want more and more and more of you, Lord Jesus. We weren't meant to go through life alone, to carry the burden on our own.
Can't go back to the beginning. Can't control
again.
Desire is to know you. Surrender.